Hello friends, myself Hemantem Patel, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Engineering Department, Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Technical Education and Research Center, Navsari. Today we are going to discuss about the pulverized fuel handling system. Okay, so over here you can say fuel handling system, in which consider two systems, unit system and central system. It is also called bin system. Okay, so over here you can see the unit system, right? So what is the procedure, what is the working? So we can see over here, this is the roll call bunker. Means what? In the bunker roll call we can feed, right? So after, over here you can see this is the gate. So through the gate the coal which is introducing into the feeder, right? Over here you can see preheated air which is passing into the feeder due to the dryness of the coal, because we all know about the coal, which is first of all in coal, suppose moisture contains are present, so at that time combustion efficiency which is reduced. So that's why we are using the dry coal for the particular in the furnace, right? So over here preheated air which is supplying into the feeder for the dryness of that particular coal. After what happened, that coal which is goes into the pulverizing mill, right? What is the function of the mill? Generally we are using in thermal power plant there are number of mill for the crushing the coal into the powder form, ball mill, bowl mill, ball and race mill, impact mill, hammer mill, right? So in mill what happen, this coal which is crushing and convert into the powder form, right? So after that coal means pulverized coal which is goes into the through the induced draft fan, right? So over here you can see one line is there, right? So little bit particle which is remaining, which is goes also into the pulverizing mill for the crushing the coal, right? So after the crushing the coal and it will be become a powder coal which is goes through the preheated secondary coal and goes into the burner, right? So in the burner a little bit preheated air is required for the combustion purpose. That's why over here preheated secondary air which is introduced into the furnace, right? So this is the unit system, right? So in unit system what happened? Nothing but just the coal which is goes into the feeder after we are supplying the preheated air for the drying of that coal, right? After that coal which is goes into the pulverizing mill, over here what happened, the coal which is converted into the powder coal and which is passing through the induced draft fan and it goes into the burner, right? So in burner we are using powder form pulverized coal, means efficiency of that particular boiler or efficiency of the combustion will be increased. That's why we are using the powder form coal compared to this lump form coal, right? So which are the advantages of unit system, right? So I just read particular advantage. It is simple in layout and cheaper than central system. Central system we will discuss further. The coal transportation system is simple because directly coal which is introduced into the coal bunker and which is passing into the feeder and after in coal mill. It allows direct control of combustion from the pulverizer. The maintenance charges are less and space requires are less. In the replacement of stokers, the old conveyor system can be used. Coal which requires drying for satisfactory function of the central system is generally supplied without drying in the unit system. It afford better control of fuel feed into the furnace. So these are the advantages of unit system. Okay. Right now we are talking about the disadvantage of unit system. So first one, the mill operates at variable load as per load on the power. The total capacity of all mills must be higher than for a central system with the load factors common in practice. The degree of flexibility is less than that of the central system. Right? So central system we will discuss in the further. So basically at that time you just understand what actually differ in unit system and central system. In event of failure of the auxiliaries of one of the burner has to put off as there is no reserve capacity. The fault in preparation unit may put the entire steam generator out of the use. Strict maintenance is desired as the operation of the plant directly depends upon the pulverizing mill. There is excessive wear and tear of the fan blade as it handles air and core particles. Further over here you can see central or bin system, right? So over here you can see this is the roll call bunker, already we have discussed, right? So from that roll call bunker through the gate a coal which is introducing into the feeder. So in feeder we are supplying the hot air, right? Why we are supplying the hot air? For the dryness of that particular coal, right? So after that coal which is passing into the mill, this is the pulverizing mill. Already we have discussed about the ball mill, bowl mill, ball and race mill, impact mill, hammer mill. We can easily use for the crushing the coal into the powder form. After that powder form coal, which is through the induced draft fan and goes into the cyclone separator, right? In cyclone separator, what happened? That particular powder form coal which is falling onto the conveyor, and after remaining particles, little bit particle also passing through the induced draft fan, so that particle of coal which is also passing into the mill for the crushing that particular coal. So after powderized coal which is falling into the conveyor and through the conveyor which is passing into the central pulverized fuel bunker, right? So this is the thing. So we can store the powderized form, pulverized fuel in this particular fuel bunker, right? So after that powderized coal which is passing into the pulverized fuel feeder, after we are supplying the air through the forced draft fan, and that pulverized coal which is goes into the burner, and we all know that in burner we just combustion that particular powder form coal and we can generate the heat, and after that heat which is directly contact with the water, so water we get water evaporated and generate the steam, right? So this is the central bin system. So in this system, just over here we can store the pulverized fuel, right? So suppose this system will be sometime maybe close. At that time we can easily use that pulverized coal from particular in coal bunker through the burner. Okay, so this is the central or bin system. Advantages of central system. The central system is flexible and changes can be made to accommodate quick changes in demand. There is greater degree of flexibility as the quantity of fuel and air can be separately controlled. The pulverizer always runs at its rated load, right? Rated load, irrespective of the load on the plant. Therefore, its power consumption per ton of coal crust per hour is less. Burners can be operated independently of the operation of coal preparation. The pulverizer can be shut down when sufficient reverse reserve capacity has been achieved. The same can be used during peak load period. The fan handles only air, therefore there is no problem of excessive wear of fan blades. It offers good control over the fineness of coal. More latitude is provided in the arrangement of the bunkers. The boiler accessories are unobstructed. The labor required is less, right? So these are the advantages of central bin system, because in central bin system we are just store the pulverized coal, and whenever our plant will be closed, at a time we are using such type of pulverized coal from the that particular central bin bunker. Disadvantages of central system. The initial setup cost is high and occupies a large space. The power consumption of auxiliaries is high. Therefore, the overall power consumption per ton to coal handle is higher than unit system. There is possibility of fire hazards due to the stored pulverized coal. Okay, so this is the big disadvantage, because of the weak stored pulverized coal. So this type of fire hazard may be occurred. Possibility, the coal transportation system becomes more complex. Dryers are essential. The operation and maintenance charges are higher than the unit system of the same capacity. Okay, so generally depend on the plant, right? We are using rather than we are using a unit system or central bin system, that is depend on particular the plant capacity, right? So these are the disadvantages of central bin system. Thank you.